FiFine microphone review coming your way right now. Hi everyone, Digital David here. Today in this video, I'm going to be unboxing and reviewing the FiFine Lavalier Mic Lapel Kit. I did receive this product to review, but any opinion expressed in this video is strictly my own. If you're interested in this product, the link to it will be in my video description below. You can see how it comes packaged to you right here in a very simple retail box. Now let's go ahead, let's open it up and look at the package contents. Here are all the package contents. First up, we have a customer service and contact card. Then we have your user guide and manual right here, complete with full setup instructions, walking you through every possible scenario and device to connect the included microphones to, walking you through some tech specs as well. Then we have a nice carrying bag for everything to keep it organized and for easy travel and storage. Then you can see we have a 1-to-2 microphone adapter right here. No more passing and swapping the lapel mic to each other. You can just plug two mics in right there. Then we have an adapter that they call a 4-to-3 adapter. This is for your TRRS and your TRS devices. So this end will plug into your DSLR cameras, or it will plug into your computer if you have a dedicated microphone port. We have some additional covers for you. So two additional windscreens, one for the lapel mic and one for the headset mic. And we have another clip for the lapel mic. Then you can see we have a long extension cable right here. We have our lapel mic right here. And we have our headset mic as well. Now let's go over some of the scenarios of how to use and connect these microphones. So for iOS devices, if you have an older iPhone that has your headphone jack still, just plug the microphone in, you're all set and ready to go. If you have a newer iOS device, you have to use the dongle. So you have to get a dongle if you don't already have one that plugs in your phone or iPad's lightning port. Then you can plug in the microphone and you're all set and ready to go. The same thing can be said for Android users as well. If you have the headphone jack, you can plug directly into that. If you don't, you'll have to get a dongle for your device, USB Type-C, or maybe a micro USB. It'll depend on your device. I have a Google Pixel 3a. That phone has a headphone jack. I can plug this mic directly in with no issues. Then I can open up the camera app from my phone, and I can choose to use the external mic if I want, so I can use it without having to download anything else or buy any other adapters. If your Android device doesn't have that option from the camera settings once you have your mic plugged in, then you should try the Open Camera app right here. They walk you through how to install it on your phone, how to access the settings, video settings, audio source, and then choose external mic if present. Now for a PC, there's two options as well. So if you only have one headphone jack on your PC that is for headphones and microphone combo, so it's a one port for both, then you can plug directly into that port and use the microphone with no issues. If you have a PC that has two separate input jacks, one for like your headphones, one for your microphone, then you'll have to use the included adapter, what they call the 4-to-3 pin cable, so you can see it right there. You'll have to use that adapter to be able to use the microphone. So you can see that, very helpful guys. Here's the camera options as well with your DSLR camera. You can see that we have to use the adapter again to connect the lapel mic to the mic port. So just know you'll have to use the adapter for your DSLR cameras. Then they show you the Y connector right here, which supports two microphones, the TRRS female ends. So you can see how they're using it. One's using the headset mic, one's using the lapel mic. We can see that in more detail right here, guys. Plugging it into the device, then plugging both microphones in. They also have the extension cord option as well too. 79 inches in case you're wondering, 2 meters, so a little bit more than 6 feet. Here's connection options as well with the cell phone if you want to use both, so see how they're doing it. You have the adapter if necessary. Then you have the splitter and then the two mics. Same can be said right here. So we have the 4-to-3 adapter if necessary. We have your extension cord, splitter. So color coded, everything's ready for you. So again, extension cord, Y connector, both mics. Then if you need the 4-to-3 pin adapter, extension cord, Y connector, Y adapter right there, you're all set to use both microphones. Then they have some more things on the back for you, which devices they're compatible with. iPhone XS all the way back to the iPhone SE. So you can see you may need to use a lightning adapter if you have a newer device, XS, XR, X8, 8 Plus, 7, anything that doesn't have the old headphone jack, tablets as well, iPad and tablets, Samsung and other smartphones. So wide variety and range of products this will work with. Any iPhone all the way back to the SE, iPads, Android tablets, Samsung and other smartphones right there. Now let's go ahead, let's try them out. All right guys, so I got everything set up right now. You can see I got the headset mic plugged into the extension cable that's plugged into my computer that's recording this audio right now for us in real time. This is raw, unedited audio in any way coming straight from the microphone. You see right here guys, that's where it's coming out of, this microphone. Right there. It's recorded through OBS right here. And by default, when I plugged it into my Windows 10 machine, it was at 85 for the volume level. So we can adjust that tune a second for you. So we can turn it kind of all the way up. And my Windows settings are also showing that the microphone boost is set to 10 decibels right here. I haven't tweaked it all in OBS or anything else. So that's just my Windows 10 audio settings for this microphone. So we can kind of adjust it a little bit further out if we wanted, obviously. We could go a little bit lower. It's gonna hit my chin though. We could go up. I mean, this is really flexible. It kind of stays where you want it to within a little bit of give or take from that. So you can see it right there. I kind of feel like Britney Spears a little bit wearing this mic. So yeah, guys, that's the headset mic. Now let's go ahead. Let's turn it up to 100 from Windows. So now we have it at 100. I can see we're already in the red. So I'm gonna talk a little quieter. If I talk loud like this, I can see we're getting awfully close to peaking if we haven't peaked already right there with this audio sample. But that's 100 in Windows with the 10 decibel microphone boost. I'll bring it back down to 85. You're just going to have to tweak this for your settings. If you're going to be using the computer, what you're going to be doing, guys, you'll have to tweak it yourself to get it exactly matched to your voice, the room you're in, and everything else that you intend to use this microphone for right there. But there we go. That's the headset mic using OBS with the extension cable and our Windows settings at 85. Now let's go ahead. Let's unplug it and plug in the lapel mic. Now we have the lapel mic plugged in right now. Let's go ahead. Let's open up those Windows settings too. So let's see what we got right here. So levels are still 85 for the lapel mic. Let's go ahead. Let's clip it on. So this is the mic I use normally for my review videos when I'm not in the studio and I record the audio to my Tascam recorder. So we have it plugged in, guys. That's it. I'm talking with the lapel mic. I'll move my head around. We'll go up. We'll talk for a minute. Talk to the left again. We'll talk to the right. Then we'll talk right down into the lapel mic. Kind of go all around again with our head. We'll turn over the shoulder, other shoulder. We'll keep talking. And you'll get a good sample and feel for this lapel mic. Again, you can adjust the settings however you want. Let's go ahead, let's bump it up from 85 to 100. So here's 100 now with the Windows settings for this mic. That's what we're getting with 100 set in Windows. Nothing else is being tweaked or anything like that. The audio is raw coming to you guys, so you can get a great feel for the quality of this microphone and all the equipment you're seeing here in this video today. So we're looking right down at it right now. We'll go to the left and talk again. We'll go to the right and talk again. We'll talk to the ceiling. We'll talk down low. We'll kind of move our head all around while we keep talking. We'll turn this way. We'll turn the other way as well. So that's a lapel mic at 100 as well with Windows 10. Let's bring it back down to 85. So let's see if we can get it there. 84. All right, got it to 85 again. That was the 10 decibel microphone boost as well with this guy right there. Now let's go ahead, let's plug both microphones in. So I got the lapel mic plugged in. Now we got the headset mic plugged in. Let's try to put it back on again. So now we have both microphones. So if you can see that, we got both of them plugged in right now. So we're doing the audio from both microphones right here. We're at 85. The lapel mic. We have the lapel mic. And we have the headset on. So we got both mics on. Again, that's 85 from Windows right here. Now let's go ahead. We can bump it all the way up to 100 again. We're talking with both microphones right now. Testing it out so you guys can see in real time what everything sounds like. This nice splitter does work great though. We can hear both tracks of audio from both microphones. So everything works as advertised. I think it's a nice kit. It gives you so many different cables
and connections for you. Now we're back down to 85 again. It just gives you everything you would need with a lapel mic and the headset if you like these headset style microphones. It's not my favorite, but I know it serves a purpose for a lot of different people out there, especially if you're an instructor or teacher in some capacity for you. But I love the lapel mics. They're great. I use them all the time. It's nice to pick up these extra cables and connectors that I don't have in my studio kit already. So overall, guys, decent quality. Let me know what you think about it in that comment section below.
Well, that concludes our video. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget the product link will be in our video description below. Please go ahead, check it out, and do your shopping from there. Any purchase made through that link helps support our channel at no additional cost to you. So we're really grateful and thankful for all of your support. While you're at it, can you go ahead and hit that like button for us? And subscribe to our channel. We have new content coming out daily and we don't want you to miss anything. Please go ahead and give us a follow online and make it a clean sweep. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Twitch, TikTok, Discord. You can message us on WeChat, check out our website, and join our free newsletter. Thank you guys so much for being here. Don't forget new content daily, and we can't wait to see you in our next video.